All right. There you go, T. We're live now? Oh, we're on. Hello. Welcome. That's why you gave me the signal that I wasn't looking at. I see. Well, hello. Welcome to Kraaft It Live. I'm live now. This is not Memorex. All right. What are we doing today? Okay, the last time we played with watercolors, it was my birthday, and ended up doing flowers. Like, all I wanted to do was random colors and ended up doing flowers. So I tried to get flowers out of my way by putting flowers on in my practice. So if you arrive early enough, you get to actually watch some of the practice go on, some of the setup. You get to see a few things happen. And so that's what we did. Now let's get ready. I've actually got four prepared pieces of watercolor paper. You can see two on this side and two on this side. It's like magic.
How do you know which side is the top?
The one that's up. That's
I
the
mean,
top. When we
so.
flip it over, that one will be the top.
Oh, clever.
That's just how we roll around here. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and get this brush wet, and it's got a fair amount of water on it. And we're just gonna go ahead and wet this paper.
So we have Jules here, Andrew, Lisa, Enclave, Barbara, Artfully Made, and I wish I could remember her name.
Sandra.
Sandra.
It's okay, hon. You haven't been doing this long enough for you to remember everybody's names, but someday it will work. So Jules is here, and Sandra, and I heard Andrew and all that,
Barbara.
and Barbara.
And Lisa.
All right. I'm glad you guys are here. Okay, so I
I
have a.
tell you, Enclave is here too.
Yes, you did. I'm just going to run through the whole list again. Is that what we're going to do? Okay, so what I want to do is this is going to be working wet in wet. I'm just going to. Oh, I've got my. You guys can see my palette over here, right? Okay. It means that the paper is wet, and then I'm going to put wet paint into it. Well, here, I'll show you in just a second because we're going to move on to the bottom one that has no water on it, and then you'll see the difference.
Or it
No.
doesn't spread at all.
See, so it's wet in wet. So see how I'm putting the color down and it's spreading out, right? So. Okay, I'm trying to paint here, bruh.
Sorry.
Okay. All right,
My
so
arm
then.
finally got in your
Yeah,
way.
your arm got in my way. What the heck?
Finally swapped.
All right, so I'm going to move on down to this one, which has no liquid. This one is dry, dry, dry. See the difference? Kind of, really? You don't see the obvious difference here? And I need more water on my brush. That's why I'm getting those dry strokes right there. So you really can't see the difference, T? I know people out there can see the difference. Look at what's happening to those strokes.
So these are spreading out more and these aren't.
Because this is on a dry surface and this is on a wet surface. So this is called wet in wet. This is called wet on dry. Because the brush is wet, but the paper is dry.
What happens when you just take a piece of paper and then soak it in water and then watercolor on it?
The
Would it be
water might
super
fall apart. I
vibrant?
mean, the paper might fall apart, but all
Super
right. So
vibrant.
then, the other thing you can do is get in the way of the photographer and go in here
Have you done it
with a
yet?
wet brush. Now, this is like fairly clean water, not quite, but. And get the edge wet and see how it does that.
Oh, cool.
Given that soft
Doing
edge.
that slowly.
So we get that soft edge right there. That neat. So we're going to do that again over here.
Sometimes I wish the photos would just post themselves because I have to go off and post them and not take pictures.
I'm just grateful that you take the pictures, T. And so are the people out there. So T-Dog takes pictures and posts them to Instagram. If you guys are unfamiliar with that by now, I don't know where you've been, but it's possible you might be new here. If you are new here, then we have an Instagram that we post close-ups on, and that's T-Dog's job, and he does a great job, by the way.
Creative Wings just popped up.
All right. Well, welcome. So if you are new here, let us know so that way we can help you along. If you're watching us in the replay and you'd like to join us for one of these live adventures, you can check our YouTube live channel. Always has, when we're done here, I put up the one for next week, and you can set a reminder. It's actually kind of cool. YouTube, hopefully, if all is working well and the planets have aligned, it will tell you that we have gone live, which is always nice when
it
doesn't.
Did you go live this morning on Instagram?
We did. Yeah, it was something was up with Instagram, though, because like when I got off the live, like we only had one person watching, so obviously didn't really share very much with anybody. But when I got off, it was telling me that there was nothing for me to save or to share. It was really weird. But it was there. It was there afterwards. After a while, it was there. Just strange. Technology is so cool sometimes, and then sometimes it's a bugger. All right, so those are kind of cool. They kind of look almost like feathers, sort of. Like two sets of feathers. These ones look more like feathers. I like those. I can actually work with those. Once they're dry, I think I might do something special there. We'll see. These sort of look like blue bananas down here, but whatever.
Jules said she watched the replay on Instagram.
Oh, awesome. Thanks, Jules. All right, so we're just going to let those dry on the back side. This is kind of clever, I think.
I thought that was the front side.
Well, now it's the back side because it's drying.
Yeah, but now this is the front
right,
side.
Right, so this is the front side.
Oh, my word.
Yeah.
You're going to confuse everybody.
You're going to confuse everybody? I think I'm just confusing you, dear. I think that's it. All right, we're going to go in with some two-tone, some green and blue, I think. So these are my Mission Magello Mission Gold series. I like to use these when I'm screwing around. It's when I don't have like a real, I want to make something to sell in product mentality. It's like, I want to mess around or I want to experiment. That's what I use these for the most. And right now, I think I just want to work on, I don't know, some kind of leaf shapes maybe in a pattern.
Andrew just said down the up staircase.
There you go.
Or something like that.
Or something like that.
What about up the down stairwell case?
I'll leave you two to debate about that. I mean, I think that's totally up to the guys to figure it out. That's the two of you. Might be.
No, the glass just has stuff in it. That shut him up.
Yeah. All right, so this is fun, just making shapes and patterns. I don't know if they're going down or if they're going up. Yeah, if you drop that phone, it'll hit. First, it'll make a mess in the paints.
I wouldn't even do a fake out, to be honest.
Alright, I was going to put blue in this. Did you know that? Yeah, apparently I did. That's not adding blue. All
Yeah,
right.
that's purple.
I'm enjoying making these patterns and things. That's what
You wanted to do
I
last
wanted
week?
to do last time. Well, not last week. Last week we did mixed media, but the week before. Oh, that color. Oh.
That's like dark pine leaves.
That's like teal or something. I don't know, but.
Andrew says you need orange, summer turning to fall. The only thing that changes in fall around here is the license plates.
Wow, that was clever, Greg.
I know.
Yeah, I'm kind of having like a boycott of fall. Autumn. The rest of the world calls it autumn or autumnal. They don't call it fall. I'm calling it depressing because I miss my changing leaves and. But you know, you can paint them, right? So maybe that's what we'll do.
Yeah, Mom, you can
You can paint
paint
them.
Stay forever.
That's right, you can. Oh, that color. My goodness. I'm gonna have to put one great big one here, I think. So this is just basically practicing strokes and using the brush and mixing color and just enjoying what I love about the medium. That's fun. I like that. I don't know if anybody else does, but
You know what that looks like
what?
From a weird
What
angle?
does it look like from a
It looks
weird
like you
angle?
took a leaf, stamp.
It does kind of look like I stamped it, huh?
Yeah.
That's kind of neat. All right, well, let's go over here with some autumnal colors. That's going to be muddy. I got to change my water. Now would be a good time to bring up some comments, Mr. Crafter.
Nice idea. Andrew says go out and paint a cactus or two.
No, I refuse. I mean, that's a great idea, but no.
Lisa says they look lovely.
Thanks, Lisa. Let's change brushes too. Let's see. I don't ever use a flat brush, so let's do it. All right, let's see here. So this is going to be some orange. Oh, I like that it's getting lighter and lighter. What'd she dibs?
The art piece.
I don't know.
All of them.
All of the art pieces.
Is that how that works? I don't know.
I don't know. Oh, this is cool. I'm working quickly because I know, it kind of looks neat, doesn't it? I'm working quickly because I don't want these this to dry before I get some of it spread out.
You're painting Lightning McQueen's next paint job.
Maria from Argentina is here.
Hi, Maria. Do I have the thing in the way here? If I'm in screen in in screen or not. You guys have to tell me, because I'm too
screen.
Busy. I'm just too busy. I can't be bothered with that kind of stuff. Is that good?
Yeah.
Oh, let's add some red into this. I don't know what color this is. I saw a poster recently. It was like an artist on one side and a regular person. This is what it said, a regular person on the other side. And it had, let's switch directions. Yeah, let's do that. It had a whole bunch of colors in the middle. And the artist or the regular person is saying, like, you know, red, yellow, green. And then the artist has the every color in between. You know, all the weird names, like peacock and plum and...
The stupid stamp color names?
No, not stupid stamp color names, mister. Freshly cut grass, or yeah, exactly right. Yeah. Too much fun. All right, let's bring more of this out. Really light on this end over here. I like this. So you can probably tell I'm going a little bit abstract. So I had some fun with Instagram Live yesterday and today and was able to put together something. Can you hand me those two sheets right there? So I did this one. And then while hanging out with Andrew and Michael, I doodled on it to make it really looks a lot more seascape-like or landscape-like than it did to start with. And then this was one that I did sort of off camera. I was just messing around. Looks space-like, doesn't it?
That first one, you know those maps that you get on the back of cereal boxes?
A map you get on the back of a cereal box? No,
yeah,
I'm not.
It looks like that, but you didn't have any patience to finish it, so you just
cut
all of the lines.
Anyway, I thought that was really fun. Very relaxing, actually. Which is kind of surprising. So, very abstract, son.
Tanya said hello.
Hi, Tanya. I think Tanya is one of Lisa's regulars, so I appreciate you coming over. It's awesome. Thank you very much, Lisa, when you share and talk about the show. It's really awesome. You guys know that Lisa does a live crafting. How often do you do that? I know you do it on Mondays. Her thing on Mondays is really cool because that's where she does the pick 10 thing that I participated in a couple weeks ago. But how often do you do that, Lisa? I'm sure she'll tell us in the chat. If you're not familiar with it yet, head over to Lisa's channel and subscribe to her so you can see when she goes live and does some cool stuff. If you like the long hangout with friends and just have chit-chatty fun, there is a lot of that going on over there. It's so much fun. And then she's got a Facebook group where you can like post things. It's kind of cool. All right, I like that. Let's leave it. Let's leave it to dry. Let's see what the other side has to offer, what it looks like after it has dried. It dried enough.
She does it every Monday night at 7 Central Standard Time.
Thank you for clarifying.
Not Eastern, not Pacific.
Central Standard.
All right, I'm going to just see if I can add some detail using this flat brush, which is something I don't normally do, so this should be scary. I don't know why I'm saying it would be scary. It's just paper, right?
You gotta pull it down.
Oh, sure. Nobody saw that?
I just did.
I'm scary, like shaking over here, and nobody saw me make that, really.
see, they just saw you do that one.
Ed, let me know when I'm in the camera.
Oh, there's just so much to do, Mr. Crafter. All right. I don't know about that one.
Vicky Ross showed up.
Hey, Vicky. How you doing?
I'm glad Andrew's Alzheimer's hasn't kicked in. He said he remembers doing that with you.
Oh, good. Because that was like yesterday that we did that. I don't know. That's not quite what I was going for, so I gotta switch brushes. I'm getting out my tiny brush, which Lynn's always makes fun of me that my brushes are way too big, and this is like the smallest brush I use, and she says it's still too big, so.
She
finds
the horsehair.
I think she really does, but I find that using smaller brushes causes more problems. For me. Ah, there we go. I think I just found the groove. How to paint a feather when you didn't intend to. Oh, that's pretty cool. Does it look like a feather, you guys?
Tanya thinks so.
All right, Tanya gets the points. You guys get nothing. You're not helping at all. Tanya gets all the points. I like that one. Let's see. Do I need to bring that one closer so you guys can see that better? There you go. Look at that. That looks pretty cool.
That is very cool.
It's called a manual zoom.
Manual zoom. I'm really good at the manual zoom. I'm going to add some green to this one. We're going to see what happens with this one. Let's see. This one's going to go down.
I like what Vicky has to say. It says, teeny brushes enable overworking unless you are coloring.
Yeah, that's how I feel about it, really. Ugh. The direction is different with this one. Hence, it's going to look more like a pine leaf.
And Andrew says that Linz is used to dealing with tiny hammy, so her perspective is different.
That's very true. My problem is I don't personally like to spend all the time with these detail things like this. I'm loving this moment right now, but you can't always just paint the hairs of a feather or whatever. What is it called? Is it called a hair? I don't know. The hairs of a feather? I don't think it is, but, you know. What do you call these things on there? Fronds?
I'm not a feather man, so what do I know?
we're just going to leave that right there. We have nothing to say to that comment.
Yeah.
Yeah, go right ahead and Google it, T-Dog. All right,
let's Google it.
BJ just showed up.
Hey, BJ. BJ in the house.
Lisa says feather fluff.
Feather fluff. I'm making some very fluffy feathers, too, so that's kind of appropriate term. Oh, Lord, it's a frequently asked question, according to Google. But we still don't know the answer, so. Oh, I'm sorry, I need to wait. I need to have patience. It's not really my strong suit.
I'll plead the fifth on that.
There's a whole feather anatomy. I have to read.
Feather anatomy. Oh, T-Dog's getting edumacated on feather anatomy right now.
All right.
Speak louder.
They can't hear you very well, so I have to repeat if you don't speak louder.
That was really loud. Did you hear that?
Wow. I didn't hear anything, actually. Mr. Crafter is in a strange mood today. It's really kind of irritating T-Dog.
There's a lot of information here, but I really don't understand what it is.
All right, manual zoom. Manual zoom. There's the details so far.
Cool.
That's pretty fun. I'm enjoying this. Is anyone else enjoying this? Maybe it doesn't matter, but...
Lisa's feeling very blessed right now.
Yay!
She cannot hear anything from T.
All right. So, did she say she's feeling blessed, or was that you?
Yeah, that was
you
me.
Being funny.
Yeah.
Oh boy, I could do this all day, it looks like. We just might. Alright, T. It's taken you too long to figure it out, and then there's no Instagram pictures being taken. And you know they care way more about Instagram pictures than they do about Googling the anatomy of a feather.
While you're doing that fine painting again, I'm gonna throw up today's message.
Oh, that's a good idea.
He put a new song of praise in my mouth, a hymn of praise to our God, Psalm 43. We miss church on Sunday, and I kind of wish we didn't.
Yeah, I know. Me too. Why did we upset Lisa? Because she didn't say those words?
She said, I did not say that, T-Dog. I want to hear from you.
He's talking robotic for some reason. Oh, that's funny. It's really fun to work with your family, in case anybody out there is wondering. No, really, it is.
Well, Andrew just sent us something, but it's kind of...
Hey, you know what? Andrew is who Google turns to when Google doesn't have the answer, so.
I think he got it from Google.
No,
yeah, you don't know him very well.
Pretty sure he didn't.
So what is it? What's it called? Enlighten me.
I don't know. It
says, Bard is the tiny shaft up the vein which grows from the quill or calamus. Barbs. Okay, that makes sense.
Oh, barbs. That's what we call those things? Barbs?
I was about to say, I'm pretty sure they're called barbs because that's what it's telling me, but I'm not totally sure.
All right, we'll go with barbs. That's both Google and Andrew approved. Barbs it is. And there they are in close-up shot. There you go. That's not too bad. All right, you go ahead and take a photo. I think they need gold, but, you know, we'll wait. That's actually cool, he says. Wow, that's actually cool. Well, thank you. You just got tons of pictures to take?
Yeah, I have to make up for the...
For the search of the barb. Searching for the barb.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, so now what I think I want to do with these is some doodle marks. I don't know if it'll look like scales or not. That's kind of what I was thinking it would do.
Did you hear what I said, Mom?
I was trying not to listen to you, but you keep repeating it like you need me to hear. Thanks for getting out of my barbs.
Lisa said, Yes, some gold, please.
Yeah, I'm going to wait, though, till it's dry.
And Andrew said the purple ones need copper.
Yeah, I'm going to put whatever the gold... you know I have that thing that has, like, 5 golds on it? We're going to use a couple different ones on there, I think. That's going to... That's the only thing that makes sense. Okay, now we're getting into scallops, not... I don't know. That kind of look like fish scales a little. Kind of. I don't know. We shall see. Let's work on some hatching. Awesome. So this is Craft Shack. You get to learn about crazy things, not just fun art facts, or even not so fun art facts. All right, here we go. Like it's a species. Why don't I do something totally, totally random? I'm just going to zoom in. So I don't have to keep picking it up. What do you think of them apples? Whoa. Ultra manual zoom right there. Yeah, that's the quality production right here. Yeah, quality production. Yeah. Odd little things, yes. I think that's probably the mantra. I call it, I say, where fun is to be had and mistakes are bound to happen, but more often than not, it's odd little things we do. To be truth. Smart. I don't think they can hear you at all, so. Oh, you know that? You know that. That's why you're mumbling over there? T's having his own little live stream with us. He's just not including the audience today. Yeah, but half the time you engage with me, and then when I answer you back, they have no idea what in the world I'm saying that for. It's like a trap, is what it is. She finally realized the trap. Yep, I did. I have no idea what I'm doing. I'm just practicing brushstrokes and making some pretty cool art pieces. So you know what? You know what we can talk about? We kind of mentioned this last week, and I was kind of caught off guard by talking about this, but I think I'm a little bit more ready to discuss it. You put me on the face cam, so now I can look at the folks when I talk about it. Okay. So you put me on the face cam, and now I'm totally confused about what I was going to say. All right. So we are going to be doing a thing. We're going to be doing a thing called 100 in 100 days, right?
Yes.
Yes. And the way this works is I have been preparing some art pieces so I can sort of get ahead of the game. But we're going to be doing, as of October 1st, 100 art pieces in 100 days. And the goal is to give all of those away to travelers. So if you are on the fence about becoming a traveler, or maybe you're even going, what in the world even is a traveler, which is fine. If that is the case, please ask so we can help clarify what a traveler is. But our goal is to give 100 of those away to 100 travelers. And those of you who already are travelers, you will get first dibs as soon as we go live with that. So pretty cool, right? Doing what alphabetically? Art pieces available? No, that's actually the whole reason why I'm confused about, not confused, but not excited about announcing it yet, officially announcing it, because I have this really great plan, and I want to make sure that people get the one they want, but how do you know it's the one you want if you haven't seen them all? So, so basically what I'm going to do is put out a newsletter with, I have to turn it to get this last one in. I'm going to put in a newsletter with the choices so far, and then those are going to go to the current travelers that are currently signed up as travelers right now. They're going to get first dibs on what I already have to offer, which I think we have 10 already in the works. And then as we go along in the 100-day fun, anybody who wants to join and sees one they like, they get to claim it. And the way it'll work is after you have been a traveler for 3 months, I will send it to you. So that's the way we're doing it. Kind of cool, right? Get your own piece of Craft Shaak art by supporting free videos. That's what it is. That's what it comes down to. And you get a whole bunch of other stuff too, but the, you know.
Is that like the main draw of becoming a traveler? Is you get an art piece?
For the first 100 days, yeah. See, you did it again. Now, do they know what I'm talking about? What I just answered you about? Who knows? All right. This is turning out quite nice.
Now I need to ask Tanya if she understanded.
Understanded?
Understood that.
Understood what?
Lisa says, please re-explain how to become a traveler.
Oh, gotcha. Okay, so becoming a traveler is simple.
Thank you, Michael.
It's simple, sort of. Thank you, Michael. That's awesome. A really cool gift from our friend Michael Daniels. That's really cool. So, explaining now. We really got to work on that, guys. yes, explaining how to become a traveler. That's the next thing I was doing. It is on our website. You go to, there's a link down in our description. You go to that link, and it will take you to the support options page. On that page, you will find everything that we do. All of our places that you can support the Craft Shaak by either purchasing art or products with the art on it, or even just doing a regular donation if you're so inclined and you don't want to do a monthly membership, etc. There's a whole bunch of things on there. You can actually even find our Instagram right there. If you're not an Instagram user, you can actually look at it right there on our page. But the cool thing is it says become a member, and you click that button and it takes you to the registration page. And once you're on the registration page, you have two choices. You can be a hitchhiker or you can be a traveler. And a hitchhiker is free. Just like it would be if you were hitching a ride out there, you'd get a free ride as a hitchhiker. And that's just basically getting our newsletter as well as our freebies that we give away every once in a while. We have right now, we have the line art is available for download for anybody who is a hitchhiker. And then if you want to become a supporter, which we call a traveler, then you could go ahead and sign up there as a traveler. This one sort of looks like a whale to me.
Should I tell you that Andrew put a link to the register page?
That's nice of you, Andrew. Thank you.
And did you say something about the hitchhiker stuff as well?
Yes, I did. I have no idea what that animal is, but there I painted one.
Which one?
I don't know, this thing right here. I don't know what that is, but...
It's a whale.
It sort of looks like a whale, sort of. But it's a whale with nostrils.
Yeah.
It's not really, but... I know. This looks like a wing right
Some
here.
People are going to be like, no, that doesn't look like that. But
pretty
you're
much,
gonna put a
but
blob
you know
down
what?
On the piece of paper, and they're gonna be like, "Hey, look, it's a dog with a cape."
Yeah, welcome to Kraaft It Live, where we see stuff in the art.
Yeah, no one said anything about that tonight.
Oh, I see where the nostrils are.
Are you gonna post that on Instagram?
Yeah. Have to.
You can see a close up of the whale on Instagram.
You made a comment about it. See, now that looks like a whale as well.
Does it?
A whale is like peeking its head out. Oh. Like just peeking its head out.
I thought it was a bird. Like
no,
it's
a whale.
The...
I've declared it.
Put the debate up on Instagram. Whale or bird feather, feathers, wing, whatever.
Oh, like it's just going out of the camera view.
Yeah, I don't know what I'm doing now. I'm literally just putting lines in. These are just fun. Would you quit with the whale? Everything can't be a whale.
All of them
are now whales. Just like that, it's all a whale.
That's a whale's tail.
Let me get a picture of all of them. Seriously, you don't see a whale there?
No, I don't see a whale here. I think we need to eat dinner before we do the show. Like, that should be a new rule.
No, that is a fish.
You think so?
Yes. No head. Okay.
I think we're all three of us were a little goofy before we got started because we have had no dinner.
Speak for yourself.
Oh, you did eat, didn't you?
Yep. I try to get you guys to eat, but it doesn't work. So
I can't eat before
no,
we do the
no.
show. It's too
Andrew
difficult.
Andrew says it is a variegated whatchamacallit.
A variegated whatchamacallit. I would agree with that.
Michael says having a whale of a good time.
Exactly.
Look, dad jokes.
BJ says, Heather, my thought process has really been affected. H-U.
Yeah, I know, sweetheart, and it's okay. I would not worry about it if I were you, darling. You take care of you, please. Big prayers going up for our friend DJ, you guys. And for Abe as well. Lots of love for that family. You guys are always in my prayers, always, always, always. You know, that's something we haven't talked about in a while, too. If you are someone who is in need of prayer and would like to have someone praying for you, I offer that as well. So please consider taking a look at our website. There is a Contact Us in the menu. You are welcome to use that for prayer as well. If you just, you don't even have to tell me what's going on. If you don't want to, that's fine. Just go ahead and send a message. Let me know. I'll add you to our list. I count it very much an honor to be able to carry those prayers for you. So, I'm just going to leave that one. I don't even want to mess with it. Okay. All right, let's go with that. That looks pretty cool. You think these are dry enough up here to put on gold? I think so. Don't you? Good. I'm glad you agree. I'm going to flip it around and do it this way. And we're going to put the golds in here. Man, our time together has flown by. Absolutely yep. flown by. I thought that I would get to all four of these, but I'm not sure that I will get to finish even these two right here. All right. This is like a red gold. Can you guys see this? No, you can't. Let's put it up here. This one here is called red gold. Oh, that's good. You guys can see that, right? Yeah. All right. So this is like a red gold. I would call it as copper-ish as we can get with our watercolors today. Just going to swirl that around a little bit.
Patty just showed up just in time for the gold.
Hi, Patty. We're glad you're here. All right. This one is going to get some little dots. They're going to increasingly get smaller. All right, those look somewhat alien at the moment, but.
What? Aliens.
Oh. Kind of creepy. Don't say an insect of any kind. I don't want to see an insect. It's gonna be gold on that feather, so you just shush.
Was it feather?
Oh my goodness, really?
I'll watch you do
it. Thank you. Appreciate it. I appreciate that. You just walk away, young man. Walk away. Walk away.
I wanna watch you.
You're not allowed to watch if you're gonna say weird things. Okay.
I'm saying things that everybody thinks this is.
I don't know. I don't know. I'm concentrating, can you tell? Because I can't say a word.
This is the silent portion of
the show. Is the silent portion of the show where Heather concentrates. Hopefully you guys are talking out there amongst yourselves. Not that Mr. Crafter would ever tell me.
I tell you some of this.
Maybe
stuff.
Everybody's left and you just don't want to hurt my feelings. Is that what it is?
Tanya wants to know what kind of paints are the metallics.
Ah, yes, that is a great question, Tanya.
Why don't you go through the paints that you've used tonight?
What do you mean?
What you've used.
All right, so these are Kuretake, Ganzai Tambi Kuretake set. It is, I think they're called Starlight or something like that, but they're a fun set to get on Amazon. Cool. Lots of fun. The colors that we've used are all Magello, Mission Gold, series. And that's pretty much walking through all of the watercolors we used tonight, Mr. Crafter.
What's the paper you've used?
The paper is...
Is
this? No. The paper is Fabriano Cold Press. I buy it in sheets. They're like 22 by 30 or some crazy number like that. And then I cut it down by just folding it and tearing it. Oh Lord, you posted a picture of it with like some sort of comment about
No, I didn't comment on it.
lies.
I just said, ask or tell me what this is. So we'll see what people
We'll
say.
see what people say, I guess. Okay, so there is the feathers. What do you think of them apples? Oh, I missed one. Nobody's paying any attention. I missed one.
How'd you miss one?
Because nobody's paying attention.
There is only one person painting, so.
BJ says, those feathers will be splendid in the morning. You think little elves in the night.
Cute.
You'll think little elves in the night.
That's cute.
Can't believe you missed one.
I know. I know, I'm terrible. What can I say? All right, don't overdo it. Vicky is right. It's very easy to overdo. All right, that looks pretty cool. Can you guys see the shimmer on it yet? I don't know if you can see it.
Jules, it looks like a female troll tea dog.
A female troll.
I can't believe she encourages him like
I
that.
know. They're friends, I guess. Whatever. All right, we'll just leave that and then we'll move on to the other one. I think these are cool, but I'm just going to splatter it with some gold. Get this bigger brush in the gold and see what it does.
Gold makes everything better, says Patty.
Patty is correct. I totally agree with Patty. Patty gets all the points. Patty and Tanya have to share the
Was gonna say
points.
you gave them to Tanya
I
already.
know,
That's
I
not
know. Well,
fair.
they're fictitious points, so we can really give them to as many people as we want.
Wow.
So it's all good. All right. So there is. I just wanted to splatter it. Can you guys see the splatters? That's not bad. Let's turn it over and see what happened on the other side. That's all dry. Oh. Some gold on those are gonna be cool. We got time, yeah?
Oh, yeah. Andrew says the only thing better than adding gold is adding bacon.
Oh, great. Now I want bacon. I haven't eaten dinner yet. I'm afraid. Can you believe this? I'm like afraid of what I want to do with this. Let's see.
We had bacon on a donut the other day, didn't we?
Oh, yes, maple bars with bacon on it.
Yeah. I
Yep,
think a
that
full
we
strip
did.
of bacon on a maple bar would be really good.
I agree. That tiny little piece they put on there was just silliness.
Yeah.
They put like, I mean, it wasn't even like a bite.
No.
Like, why even bother at that
I mean, they
point?
make maple flavored bacon, so what? Why wouldn't that be just to die for? Lisa says, do not be afraid.
I'm trying, Lisa. I'm trying. I'm the thing that I'm afraid of is, do I want it to be like, I can't decide how I want it to go. I want this like skinny tip here.
And Enclave says, popcorn is better.
Popcorn and bacon? Or bacon and maple donuts?
I don't know.
Or
Bacon and popcorn.
popcorn and maple donuts. What are we mixing with the popcorn? Because popcorn and M&Ms, you know, is my favorite treat of all times, right? You know that, right?
And Patty says, when you eat pancakes, you get syrup on bacon, so.
Amen to that. Oh, now we're gonna have to have pancakes.
Yeah, Andrew said, or Enclave says popcorn is better than bacon.
Oh.
I don't know. It depends on the moment.
Yeah, I'm not totally sure I agree with that, but that's okay. We don't have to agree. It's all right.
Bacon flavored ice cream, Andrew says.
Oh, interesting. Interesting.
Why did we start talking about food?
I'm not really sure. People are torturing me. I think you started it, actually, didn't you?
I don't know.
Oh, probably. No, it was Andrew. As I recall.
You actually have a recall?
I did. Yep, I remembered.
You didn't show off your new hairdo either, did you?
Well, you put it on screen. I didn't talk about it, but I didn't really do my hair tonight either, though. Oh,
our
you're putting it.
Made said I made lemon pancakes the other day.
What? I did not see a picture, so it didn't happen. That's the rule in our little club, is it not? We have a seriously, Sandra and
that other person,
Sylvia, and I have like food war pictures. Oops, messed that one up. We'll just pretend it's fine though. It's interesting. I gotta see it on the screen to see what I like about it. It's got gold on it. How can you not? And I don't know what to do in here. I'm thinking of squares. Okay, I don't know what that was. Something just fell. I'm going full abstract on this one. Full on abstract geometry and stuff. Can you guys see that? Probably not. That's kind of nifty, isn't it?
That is really cool.
I'm going to change up the golds, though, as we go through this, just like I changed up the red, orange, yellows. Love it, love it, love it. So it just sinks into me that that Michael did one of them $5 super chat things.
Yes.
And we were like right in the middle of talking about ways to support. And I don't think that I've ever talked about the super chat as a way to support the Kraaft Shaak. So people ask me often how... You know, because we used to have that Patreon thing, and it was simple. People just go to Patreon and support through Patreon. And since we don't have that anymore, it's not as clear as to how to support free videos on YouTube, because I don't know if everybody is aware of this or not, but video getting paid to do videos on YouTube is not really a lucrative thing. YouTube doesn't really pay you very much if you are not a very large channel. But anyway, so we've never talked about being able to support through Super Chat. So that is also another way that you could, if you wanted to do like a one-time donation thing. It's not a monthly, because I know that bothers some people to do the monthly things, you know. Did you know that, Greg?
Yeah.
Like some people don't necessarily want to, you know, do like a sign up thing or whatever. And I don't blame them, because that you never know what's going to happen with it, for one thing, but two, you never know if like you can really afford to do something monthly. Sometimes you have a little bit of extra, that's fine, but
I thought you were going somewhere different with that.
Oh, like what?
Yeah, and things happen in people's lives that
well, and
are
that's
no different than ours.
No,
I mean,
different than ours.
Happens.
Exactly right. Exactly right.
So we hope that we're not making people feel pressured to do something.
Yeah,
like
and it's
really
such a
don't
weird.
Do.
Yeah, it's such a weird place to be when you're talking about this, because people ask, and you know, you want to answer the questions, but to answer the questions over and over and over again, it's helpful to be able to say it one time on a video, You know, it's a little bit easier, but at the same time, I'm not talking to everybody. If you're enjoying the free videos and you don't feel the need to share, then don't. I mean, that's not hurting anybody. We're still going to put up videos. We're still going to do what we do. It all works out in the end. We know. Exactly. Watching the videos is supportive. Good point, Tita. Good
Watching,
point.
commenting, subscribing,
Yep,
liking.
when you hit the like button, when you subscribe, when you share, anybody watching right now could share. That's even also a fun way to support, totally free and
Yeah,
cost nobody
that's the part
anything.
about that is that's absolutely free.
Yep.
No credit card required.
No credit card required. That's right out of the mouth of T-Dog right there. All right, I'm going to put in just a couple of these solid squares because it's really kind of cool to have. I think I want to put another one of those. Let's see, one more. Just going to do one right here. Because it's got such great contrast. Oh, I was off this. So, way to do your guys' job there. Whatever.
You were on the screen.
I think I'm going to do one right here. I don't know what you call this when it goes like smaller, smaller, smaller.
To small. Big to small. That's what you call it.
All right, we're going to call it big to small right there in the middle. Okay, so those are really hard to see. Probably an Instagram photo would have been a good thing right at this point in
Yeah.
time, but that's fine, whatever. It's all good.
BJ says warm M&Ms till softish. You'll always eat them like that.
I love M&Ms, especially with my popcorn. That's like my number one treat. So, all right, let's go ahead and expose everything. Are you good? So we're going to carefully take our tape off.
Our potato.
Our patape.
Carefully as you bend.
Not usually. This paper does pretty well with this tape. I got some new paper for my birthday. It does not like being taped by any tape. It gets ripped just looking at it, I think.
Oh, Andrew. You said, wait, this is a family show.
Okay, well then don't repeat it, whatever he said. Okay. I don't know why you're doing that either. You don't have to take those photos.
They're important.
But they're important, he says. Oh my goodness, I love the reveal. Like, that's so
I know,
awesome
that's
to get
one of
those
my favorite photos.
sharp, crisp edges. We might need to doodle with some black pen on that one and this one too. Look at that. You guys see that?
Yeah, look at that shimmer. Shine.
Mmm.
Tasty.
Nummy, nummy, nummy. I'm gonna set those aside over here. Flip it back over to the right side. Right?
Is this the
And
top or the bottom
this
now?
is now the top again.
But
I know it's just gonna
oh.
drive you crazy all night, isn't it? We're almost done, so you can get over it. It helps if you pull it at a 45-degree angle away from the paper, but you know, whatever. I'm so good at the taping down that I'm making it difficult.
Yeah, she used a whole roll to tape them down.
I did not. I did use, however, the very big masking tape because I'm out of the regular sized one. And I'm ripping the paper as I speak. Okay.
Sandra loves the leaves and the whales.
Leaves and the whales. This one is going to be called whales, isn't it? I only intentionally painted one whale. This kind of looks like coral or something, but might be because I have under the sea going in on my head here. That's cool. Trying to catch the shimmer shine, that's not working out so well.
So which one was the intentional whale?
The one with the nostrils. That was the intentional whale, the one with the nostrils. Can you guys see that? Yeah, I know. All right, last one. Last one is the feathers. What do you guys think of that? Sort of overdid it there, Vicky.
Birds of a feather.
Too much fun, you guys. That was a great night of abstract painting with watercolors. Too much fun. I can now drag this thing up so we can see everything at once, right?
Yep.
There's my messy palette and everything. And
Andrew says, just call it variations on a theme.
Variations on a theme. It is so dubbed. And this was from Monday's Instagram. If you missed that, that's another perk of the Travelers. Those will get posted this weekend. The Instagram lives that we do will get posted this weekend for the Travelers to be able to watch anytime they want, because they only last like 24 hours or something on that Instagram place. So anyway, there you go, guys. I think that's it. We're going to call it done. Thank you, everybody, for joining us. I hope that you enjoyed Kraaft It Live tonight. We are live every Tuesday night, hoping nothing ever goes wrong to change those words and call me a liar, but that's where we're at. Thank you, Mr. Crafter, for a great night. T-Dog, as always, the pictures are amazing. Can't wait to look at those. And thanks, everybody in the audience, for joining us live and recorded. We will see you later. Have a crafty day, everybody. Bye.